It's election day here on the Tech campus. We'll let you know how you can make your vote count coming up.
With May approaching fast, graduating seniors are working fast to get all the details in order for spring commencement. Find out how one group is making that process much easier next.
And gloomy weather has taken over the South Plains today, but how long will it continue? We'll have all the details in the MCTV forecast.
This is the MCTV Weekday Update.
Welcome to the Wednesday edition of the MCTV Weekday Update. I'm Will Jackson.
And I'm Maitland Rutledge. For the last few months, you've probably seen posters all over the hallways advertising candidates for this year's student government elections. Now you finally have a chance to make a difference and vote for the future leadership of the SGA.
That's right, Maitland. Yesterday morning, voting opened up online for this year's races, but you have a limited time left to make your voice heard. This year's election is only 2 days, so electronic polling will close at midnight tonight. If you want to participate, visit sga.ttu.edu and click on Spring Elections Voting. The offices up for election include Graduate Vice President, External Vice President, Internal Vice President, and President. Senators for all the various colleges are also included on the ballot. If you're not sure who to vote for, be sure to stop by the Hub's website at ttuhub.net for an in-depth look at all the candidates. You can also find full coverage from last month's executive candidate forum, and be sure to visit the Hub again tomorrow for the results of this year's election.
It may be hard to believe, but graduation is just over 2 months away. If you're a graduating senior and feel like you're running out of time, one ongoing event may save you from a lot of work. The TTU Alumni Association is hosting the biannual graduation fair this week in the McKenzie Merkitt Alumni Center. The fair is a one-stop shop to get everything in order for commencement in May.
So we've got graduation fair, which is kind of a one-stop shop for May graduates. We're doing graduation rings, we're doing announcements, cap and gown, the career center's here, graduate school has information here. It's not only for May graduates, but anyone eligible to buy a class ring right now, even though there might be a junior, can purchase it and they'll be part of the spring ring ceremony.
The spring graduation fair started on Tuesday and it finishes up tomorrow. Just stop by the McKenzie Merkitt Alumni Center between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. to take advantage of this unique event.
The month of March is Women's History Month. People around the world are celebrating the accomplishments of females throughout history, and Texas Tech is no exception. In observance of Women's History Month, the University Archives has installed two special exhibits on campus. Women Who Shaped History features two collections of memorabilia and pictures recognizing staff and students who have made significant contributions to the university. This year, the exhibit is honoring five women who have made long-lasting impacts on the university. The list includes former Lady Raider basketball coach Marsha Sharp, the first female SGA president Maxine Fry, Hortense Williams Dixon, who was the first woman to receive a doctorate degree from Tech, Anne Lynch, the first female master writer, and Edna Gott, a former professor and founding member of the Women's Studies program. The exhibits will be on display in the library's Croslin Room and the Southwest Collection Rotunda through the end of the semester. Students getting ready for classes today were caught off guard by some big changes in the weather. After almost a week of 70-degree temperatures and sunshine, this morning greeted the Tech campus with cool temperatures and overcast skies.
Yeah, that's true, Will. The abrupt change in weather brought the sight of heavy jackets and rain boots back to campus. But how long will the dreary conditions continue? Let's take a look at the MCTV forecast. Looking outside, skies are still cloudy and temperatures are working hard to get into the 60s. We've also seen some occasional rain showers, which are keeping things cool. Overnight, we could continue to see some additional storms, but those should end by morning. Tomorrow, most of the clouds should clear out and we'll see a lot more sunshine. Highs will get into the upper 60s, but it will be a breezy day with gusts up to 30 miles per hour. Friday will see a return of the cloudy conditions, but temperatures will only drop a few degrees to the mid-60s. But starting Friday night, we could also see a return of wet weather with occasional showers lasting into Saturday morning. By Saturday afternoon, the clouds will break up, leading to more sunshine and an increase in temperatures. Saturday's high should top out in the mid-70s. Overnight lows Thursday, Friday, and Saturday will be cool but not cold, with temperatures hovering around the mid-40s. On Sunday, the sunshine will finally be sticking around and highs will finish out just below 80 degrees. Winds will be gusty in the morning, but they should settle down by the afternoon. Monday will see a continuation of the sunny, warm weather, but again, the wind could be a factor. Wind gusts are predicted to get as high as 40 miles per hour, with sustained speeds around 25 miles per hour. Tuesday looks to be a carbon copy of Monday's conditions, with highs in the low 80s and a continuation of the gusty winds. Nighttime lows all 3 days will be mild, with temperatures in the upper 40s and low 50s. Looking ahead, warm, windy weather will continue into the week, with a slight chance of rain returning by the weekend.
The week in sports has been filled with some big headlines, including a change of venue and the end of an era.
MCTV Sport 101's Billy Engel joins us now with a preview of tomorrow's show. Billy?
Thanks, guys. Coming up on MCTV Sports 101, Kyle Stafford and myself will have all the details and on our latest take on the headlines making waves around the country. Starting off, college basketball's conference tournaments are in full swing. We'll take a look at some potential upsets that could shake things up before Selection Sunday. The NFL has been busy dealing with two big stories, the trade of DeMarco Murray and Peyton Manning's retirement. We'll have our take on how both announcements will affect the 2016 season. And sticking with football, spring practice is underway for the Red Raiders. We'll have our thoughts on what to expect this fall. Join us for all that and more on tomorrow's show. Will, back to you.
Thanks, Billy. Be sure to catch MCTV Sports 101 starting tomorrow at 1 p.m. Just visit the hub at ttuhub.net and look under the COMC latest. Then check back the Thursday after spring break for more of Kyle and Billy's unique take on the world of sports.
With spring break only two more days away, most things around campus are wrapping up, but there's still a few options to cure your pre-break anxiety. Here's a look at the MCTV events calendar. Tonight, head over to the Sub Allen Theater for a chance to be amazed and entertained. Magician and mentalist David Hall is making a stop by the Tech campus on his latest tour. The magic of David Hall is a fun mix of magic, comedy, and mind reading. The show starts at 8 p.m. and it's sponsored by the Tech Activities Board, and as with all TAB events, it's free with a Tech ID.
If you're still around campus tomorrow night, the School of Music is hosting a performance centered around the unique sounds of the saxophone. The Symphonic Wind Ensemble and the University Symphony Orchestra are joining forces for one night in the Hemley Recital Hall. The special performance is being used to showcase Tech's talented musicians during the North American Saxophone Alliance's biennial conference. During the concert, saxophone soloists will be highlighted in different pieces geared towards the instrument. The concert starts at 7:30 p.m. and it's free and open to the public.
And wrapping up this week's events, TAB has a fun event that will keep you laughing all the way into spring break. Mean Girls will be screened in the Sub Escondido Theater tomorrow night at 10 p.m. The movie features Lindsay Lohan in one of her most famous roles, a teenager in high school who learns to counter cruel classmates with a taste of their own medicine. Along with the movie, TAB will also have free popcorn and drinks for all who attend. And since it's a TAB event, it's all free with a student ID.
So, Maitland, do you have any big plans for spring break?
I'm going to be going home this Friday. That's about all. What about you?
I'm going on a spring break trip to Utah with an organization I'm involved with. We're doing a service trip there, so that's going to be a lot of fun.
All right. Sounds interesting. That's all for today's edition of the MCTV Weekday Update.
Thanks so much for joining us, and be sure to check ttuhub.net every day for more news. Have a great spring break.